now to the major developments in the investigation into William Tyrrell. The toddler's foster parents have been charged with common assault on another child. And police are reportedly investigating inconsistencies around William's disappearance, including this photo of him in his Spiderman suit, taken on the day he was last seen. In it, you'll notice he's barefoot. But detectives were told when William vanished 7 years ago, he was wearing shoes. For more, I'm joined by former detective and criminologist, Dr Terry Goldsworthy. Terry, look, we can't go into a lot of detail because of legal constraints, but are developments like this and reviewing evidence a sign the investigation has new momentum?
Yeah, I think it is. And look, investigations are broken down into stages, Koshy. So I'll just walk you through them. We have the crime scene stage, which is where police go, usually where the most evidence is, the body is. We then have what we call the initial assessment stage, where police are looking for witnesses, any other forensic material, examining the crime scene to see what's the most valuable evidence. We then move into the investigation stage, and this is where the heavy lifting is done in terms of getting information for the investigators, moving from a low information state to a high information state. And then that moves into looking at the modus operandi, how did the potential offence occur, and who may have a motive to do the offence. And I think where we're seeing now is we're moving into targeting and an arrest stage. So we're coming to the end of the investigation. And you can go back at any point in time and reinvestigate new information, such as additional crime scenes.
So they're going back and re-examining those other earlier stages that they went through 7 years ago. What's likely to be happening behind the scenes right now?
Well, I think what we've seen is a number of different lead investigators or managers, I should say, in relation to this job. So, I mean, those fresh eyes are always useful because you can go back and look and see if anything's being missed. And the detail in regards to the shoe is important detail. It may not be the linchpin, but it certainly is an important one that police will be looking at. Yeah. But I think there's a number of strategies going on with the police at the moment. And firstly, you've got the physical searches going on. There's also a very strong media strategy going on. I mean, some of the commentary I've seen from the senior police in terms of this is now a murder or homicide investigation, we have one suspect, it's highly unusual to make those kind of comments before there's been any remains found or anything like that.
So I
think they've been done for a reason.
And how unusual is it to discredit the original investigation and the original team? Did they get too close to the family?
Yeah, look, that is it is unusual. And I guess, you know, I thought it was a bit of a poor choice, to be honest. I mean, those things usually dealt with internally. You don't go out and publicly, you know, put that info out there. So I was surprised that went on. You know, in terms of dealing with the family, these investigations, there should be a family liaison officer appointed who is separate from the investigation. Right. And the reason they're separate is clearly you don't want investigators becoming too close to the family for fear that they may overlook something or may just not pick up on something. So that's why there's an independence in that type of role.
OK. All right, Terry, appreciate your insights. Thank you.